the second day or epoch. The expressions evening and morning and day cannot be understood to signify 24-hour days, for neither sun nor moon was visible until the fourth day. The earth was swathed in impenetrable darkness. The word day applies to any period or epoch, as, for instance, the day of temptation in the wilderness, 40 years. Note again that we read of the day of Christ, evidently referring to the thousand-year day in which Messiah is to be king over all the earth. In the common affairs of life, we use the word day similarly when referring to Caesar's day, Napoleon's day, etc. We follow the theory that each of the 7 days of the creative week was a period of 7,000 years. This 7 times 7,000 equals 49,000 years, ushering in a grand jubilee epoch. As one after another the encircling rings of water and minerals approached the earth, they would spread out like a great canopy, but would not be permitted to fall upon the earth because of the circumambient air referred to in Scripture as a firmament. Saturn's rings have not yet fallen. God made the firmament in the second or Paleozoic day and separated the waters which were under the firmament from the waters which were above the firmament. The strongly mineralized waters above the earth, held off by the firmament and centrifugal force, greatest at the equator, gradually concentrated at the two poles, where later they broke and reached the earth, forming layer after layer of mineralized earth deposited by the water, which rushed from both poles toward the equator. These rings or belts of water and minerals followed each other as great deluges upon the earth, perhaps thousands of years apart. The deluge of Noah's day was the last of pure water only, heavier minerals being attracted first. Hence, minerals are generally under several layers of shale and soil.